Hi, this is John Carstarphen for Expert Village.
Now, we've had some problems lining up the photographs as they were taken originally in Poser. So what we've done is I've taken the photographs back into Photoshop, and I've done a simple lineup using the grids in Photoshop. And to do that, I've isolated each face and put them on different layers so that the top layer is the front view and the bottom layer is the side view, and then it's just a matter of lining up the eyes and the mouths as close as possible. And I could probably even do some scaling of one of these photographs to make them line up even more. But once that's done, then I export each image, each layer separately as a separate image and as a JPEG file. Now you'll notice that off to the sides here we have quite a bit of white space, and of course we have that green background. Now we can knock out the green background in Photoshop or another program, but what we'd have to do with this white space is we'd have to paint around the image so that we'd have this blend into a skin tone. For instance, if I were to select the paintbrush and the eyedropper tool, I probably want to take a skin tone somewhere in there and then add a new layer. And perhaps begin painting like this. And then using the blur tools and the smudge tools, I'd try to blend that in a little more so that what we'd end up with is something that looks a lot like a texture map. In other words, you have the key facial features apparent and clear, such as the eyes, eyebrows, nose, mouth, chin, and some of the creases in the face and the freckles and so forth. We'll want to keep all those detailed features, but we have to lose this stuff around the side.